Black holes are as mysterious as they are disastrous. They are a small region of space with a great amount of matter packed into a small area. They have a gravitational pull so intense that no matter or radiation can escape the event horizon. Thankfully, no black holes are near our solar system. But let's imagine, just for the next few minutes, what would happen if a black hole got close enough to our solar system that it began to devour our sun? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobre. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and let us know in the comments below a question you have always wanted to know the answer to. There are two types of black holes in the universe. The first is supermassive black holes that are found at the center of most galaxies. These are not that threatening, unless our galaxy collided with, let's say, Andromeda, which it's low-key supposed to do at some point, but let's not talk about that. It won't happen for a few billion years, so I think we're good. There is another type of black hole that does pose a threat to our solar system, and those are interstellar black holes. They are created when a star goes supernova, and spoiler alert, they are invisible because they emit no light. Unless they're consuming matter nearby, but I'll get to that in a minute. Point being, we would not know when a black hole enters our solar system. The closest black hole that we know of is about 6,000 light years away. It's called the Cygnus X1, and it's only 44 kilometers or 27 miles in diameter. It would cause absolute chaos before devouring our sun. Even though Cygnus X1 is relatively small, if it happened to pass through our solar system, or if it was even one light year away, it would begin to pull in comets and asteroids and hurl them around. The orbits of the outer planets would be altered, and the orbit of the sun would also be altered. Once it actually enters the solar system, that's when the fun stuff begins. As it passes through the Oort cloud, it would send space rocks hurtling at the planets, including Earth. The Oort cloud is a group of icy bodies that's about 186 billion miles away from the sun. Meanwhile, here on Earth, the only way we would know a black hole entered our solar system is the slight gravitational lensing it would cause, and the comets and asteroids that would be hitting our planet. When the black hole begins to tear apart gas giants and other material from the planets, it would create what's known as an accretion disk. An accretion disk is a visible region of superheated dust and gas that surrounds black holes. As the black hole got closer and closer to the sun, it would begin to draw in the sun's matter. Depending on how big the black hole is, it could take weeks or perhaps even hours. The matter that surrounds a black hole emits a ton of radiation and heat and would likely fry us. Perhaps the best way to describe what this would look like is the term space spaghetti. Get too close to a black hole and matter will begin to pull apart and stretch out like spaghetti. The black hole would swallow up the spaghetti little by little, not all at once, all the while emitting heat and radiation. And then a couple things could happen to the Earth. Any planet that got too close to the path of the black hole would be consumed. The intense gravitational pull of a black hole could also cause chaos on Earth. It could cause devastating earthquakes and supervolcanoes to erupt. Then eventually our planet also gets swallowed by the black hole. The second option is that the Earth gets knocked out of orbit and begins a journey into the black nothingness of space. Without the sun, the Earth would not be able to support life. And then there's a third option. The Earth could begin orbiting the black hole and life could live on for some time. In order for life to thrive, there needs to be a source of energy nearby. The black hole could technically become that source of energy in place of the sun. The only catch is, the black hole needs to have stopped consuming material, otherwise it will be emitting radiation. Life on Earth could be sustained for a while, but the amount of heat and light that is emitted by the black hole would likely be a fraction of what the Earth receives from the sun. It's difficult to imagine the environment on Earth at that point, and equally difficult to imagine what life would look like and how it would adapt. Well, there you have it. Once again, thanks for watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you want to go on an LBQ binge, you'll love our playlist Biggest Science Questions, clickable on the screen right now. Make sure you subscribe to notifications by clicking the bell, and we'll see you in the next video.